Today we are looking into the Cambridge IDCSE music listening paper. We are looking into Western art music, and we are specifically focusing on 20th century music and the subgenre neoclassicism today. So we are looking at section A2 from June 2019, paper 1-2. And by now we do know that this paper is a systematic listening paper, and you need to listen chronologically and in order, and then answer the questions accordingly. So subsection A2, which you are listening to today, counts 8 marks. And we will have a first playing followed by a silence, a second playing followed by a silence, a third playing followed by a silence, and then our fourth and final playing followed by a fourth and final silence, in which we get to tie up all our answers and make sure that we are done and dusted before going on to section B, which is our world music section. So I would recommend in your very first listening that you just take it in, hear what's going on. In this specific question paper, they already tell you what this music is and where it comes from. They already say and they hint at you very explicitly that this is a neoclassical excerpt. So let's hop into the questions right now, and then let's see what we do have to answer. So they do ask us which instrument is heard first, and they give us percussion instruments. So we have to listen closer to the percussion there. Then how many beats are there in each bar? They ask us then suggest a suitable Italian tempo marking for this music. So we're going to have to go into our Italian terminology there. Then explain what is meant by neoclassicism. So there's the explicit way of telling you this is a neoclassicist excerpt. Then what features of the extract show that it is neoclassical. So I really like the questions in this whole subsection. It's really concise, it's really detailed as well at the same time. So let's hop into our listening, and then we will come back to answer our questions.
Now listen to music A2 and answer the questions.
Nice short excerpt. Let's get to our questions. So which instrument is heard first? I wonder if we were paying attention there. But like I said, in the first listening, we're just gonna get a grip of it. I'm pretty sure we can already tell how many beats there are in a bar, and we can already think of Italian tempo markings to describe this music. Within a certain subsection, you don't need to necessarily answer from the first question you see to the last question. You can take your time within an excerpt. Of course, with a whole exam, you need to go section A1, section A2, section B1, B2, B3, and so on. But within subsection A2, for example, you don't need to answer the very first question you see first. So it doesn't need to go 5, 6, 7, 8, A, 8, B. You can definitely answer question 6 first, or even question 7. And I think that's what we're going to do now. Let's answer question 6. How many beats are there in each bar? So I definitely felt that in 4-4 time. However, without the sheet music and without really going deep into all the conventions of neoclassicist music, without all those variables in front of us, and it is very tricky to specify whether it's actually 2 or 4, so Cambridge will accept both 2 or 4 beats. Then a suitable Italian tempo marking for this excerpt, it's definitely quite moving, so either an allegro or an allegretto or anything along the lines of allegro. That's a nice Italian word. One of the words you first learn when you think of Italian tempo markings. And any variation of allegro should do here. It's definitely not slow, so don't go with the slow tempo indications. It's also not too fast, so not a vivace or a presto, but definitely something along the lines of an allegro. Then we can already hop into question 8a to explain what is meant by neoclassicism, because we don't need the actual excerpt to answer this question. We just need to know our 20th century music and our 20th century features. So remember, Cambridge does specify very specifically in the syllabus that for IGCSE level, you need to know three subgenres of 20th century music, that being neoclassicism, minimalism, as well as impressionism. Now, of course, they do sneaky stuff in the papers. They do throw in some jazz and musicals, which it's not in the syllabus, but I would definitely advise you to go ahead and also understand those things, because I have thrown it in before. Not that it's too tricky or too difficult to answer the questions based on the excerpts that they have given in the past, but it is quite good to go through this so that it doesn't catch you off guard in the middle of your listening exam. So back to this specific question, explain what is meant by neoclassicism. Now, of course, this is music composed in the 20th century based on features of classical music or baroque music. So this is basically new music based on old music. Okay, so let's go ahead and listen to the extract once more, and we're going to zoom closely into question 5, which instrument is heard first, and also question 8b, what features of the extract actually show that it is neoclassical? So what features show that it is, you know, new music based on old music? So let's hop right in, and then we can answer those last two questions.
Music A2, second playing.
Okay, so we can definitely answer our last two questions. So of course the instrument that is heard first is the snare drum. And then features of the extract that show it is neoclassical. We definitely have the melodic use of the brass, especially in the trumpets there. We have a big section of trombones. Also we have that harpsichord coming there. But it's not in the style of baroque. It's harpsichord but used in a non-baroque type of way, in a new style. So definitely neoclassical there. And of course, in brackets, I do show us that this question is worth 3 marks, so we need to give 3 facts there. If you don't say any of those, you can say a few other things. For example, we can refer to the combination of unusual instruments together. We can also say that there's a lot of change in the orchestration. We hear trombones, and we hear harpsichord, and we hear this, and we hear that. And it's very interchangeable here, which is not common, you know, in the baroque period or in the classical period specifically. So it's these instruments but used in a very new way. There's also some interesting modulation, so relationships to unusual keys. There's some syncopation, also some dissonance. So any of those should give you your marks there. And if you do have anything else to say that makes musical and logical sense, that ties in with this very specific excerpt, Cambridge will also give you your marks there. So I hope that this has helped you with regards to your Cambridge Music Listening Paper, if they happen to ask you something about neoclassical music.